مدة يدي. أهلا أخي أهلا أخي.
بسم الله، لا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, all praises to Allah. We send peace and salutations upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah and welcome back to Ahlan Akhi with me, Sameh Jad. It is time for the daily reminder, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those people who listen to the advice or the reminder and they follow the reminder and they practice upon it. Allahumma ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. Today, inshallah, in the daily reminder, we're going to be speaking about the importance of khushu' in salah, the importance of developing khushu' in our salawat. Normally, khushu' means to humble yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this khushu' is not only in salah. Khushu' is not only in salah, but khushu' is in every action, in every ibadah. A person should have khushu' in that ibadah. Khushu' in dhikr, khushu' while you're reciting the Quran. Khushu', humble yourself when you're doing any ibadah for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have this khushu' to Allah. But specifically in salah, today we're speaking about khushu' in salah. Having this khushu' in salah. And Allama ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah defined this khushu' by saying قيام القلب بين يدي الرب بالخضوع, that your heart will humble and will tremble to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you will feel that your heart is attending, your heart is there understanding what is happening. Subhanallah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describe his anbiya alayhimus salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to describe them by saying وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ. They used to be humble servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The person is so close from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the position of sujood. Why at the position of sujood specifically? It is for this reason of khushu', because the khushu' is at the peak, at the time of salah, of sujood, the khushu' is at the highest level. So when we are doing salah with khushu', we performing our salawat with khushu', we feel the sweetness of the salah. We enjoy the salah. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كان إذا حزبه أمر هم إلى الصلاة. When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to find any difficulty outside of salah, any hardship, etc., he used to return to salah, because salah with khushu' is so sweet. Salah with khushu', you feel so connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the tough times also, if you're facing any difficulty and you make two rak'at of salah with the intention and you have khushu' to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you're reciting your Fatiha beautifully, in a slow manner, you're doing your ruku' in a slow manner, you're doing rafa' from ruku' in a slow manner, and you say subhana rabbi al-a'la in a slow manner, and you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you relate your matter to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you feel the sweetness of the salah. And I'm sure many of you already tried this, yani many of you already tried this and you saw the sweetness of that salah. Sheikh, one day I made salah, mashallah, it was beautiful. This is the salah with khushu'. Allah SWT say, أفلح, قد أفلح المؤمنون. Successful are the believers. الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون. Those who are خاشعون in their salah, they will get success in this life and in the next life. You will get success. And I don't find anyone who is successful, any believer who is successful in his life, except that you will find his salah, mashallah, beautiful. He's making salah on time, he or she. Making salah on time and making salah with khushu' in a beautiful way, subhanallah. Those who are from young age right until mashallah the old age, they are keeping on this punctual on their salawat and they making salah on time. Those people, they have success. They have success in their salah. And maybe there are other people who are making salah but without khushu', it's not affecting them. It's not affecting them. Or it's not accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That salah itself is making dua against the person. ضيعك الله كما ضيعتني. Can you imagine your salah is making dua against you? A person is making salah and the salah says, ضيعك الله. May Allah make you lose. Because you lost me. Because you didn't make me with khushu'. You didn't perform that salah with khushu'. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن الرجل لينصرف من صلاته ولم يكتب له إلا عشر صلاته. Maybe someone finishes his salah and what is written from his salah is just one-tenth of it. One-tenth of it. Not even one-quarter of it. Not even one-third of it. One-tenth of it only has been written for him as thawab. And maybe someone is going to leave his salah, and there is nothing has been written for him. A salah, he didn't get any reward for it. He was just making some gymnastic exercise. Because there is no khushu' in that salah. No khushu' in the salah. Another narration mentioned that maybe someone is making salah for 60 years and not one single rak'ah been accepted from him. Why? That's a serious situation. It is because it's missing that important thing, which is khushu', hudurul qalb. The heart wasn't there. So one day a person was telling me, Sheikh, as soon as I say Allahu Akbar and I start making my salah, the thoughts from everywhere comes to my mind. I start thinking of my children. I start thinking of my study. I start thinking of what my wife is cooking for me. And I start thinking different thoughts, ya Sheikh. When you say Allahu Akbar, as soon as you just say Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest. Why we say Allahu Akbar in salah? Why do you say Allahu Akbar in salah? Have you ever thought of that? Why do we say Allahu Akbar in salah? What is the wisdom? Allah is the greatest. Allah is greater than your dunya. Allah is greater than your children, than your wife, than your family. Allah is greater than your business. Allah is greater than everything. Allahu Akbar. You're raising your dunya is behind me. You imagine, you're raising now. Dunya is behind me. Allahu Akbar. We need to think of that. We need to imagine and picture this when we make salah. Allahu Akbar. Dunya behind me. Now, khalas. Allah is the greater. The greatest. We leave everything behind. Now we're starting salah. Now let me give 5 minutes with focus to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those 5 minutes let it be with focus to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Khushu' ya ikhwa. We want to develop khushu' in our salawat. Those of you who are making salah at home, make sure that place you're making salah is so calm. Make sure you choose a place where you can make salah. But don't come and you stand in front of the TV or you come where the children are playing and you say, I'm going to make salah with khushu' here. How are you going to make it with khushu'? Make a place, a specific corner in your house for the salah with khushu'. So you can make a proper salah that will reflect on you, that will give you the provision until the next salah. Until the next salah. That salah will just deliver you to the next salah. It's like a boat. The salatul fajr is like a boat to make you reach till salatul zuhr. And from salatul zuhr, it's a boat to take you to salatul asr. And every salah deliver you to the next salah safely. If you did it with khushu'. If you didn't do it with khushu', you will suffer in between. You will have some issues in between. Now let's do it with khushu'. Your salah should be done with khushu'. So you get this falah, you get this success, inshallah. So choose the correct place. That khushu', ikhwa, starts from wudu. Right from wudu. You make wudu and you make the intention. I'm going to make my salah now. I don't want dunya in this matter. I want to focus. I don't want any whispers of shaitan. As you're making wudu, you're getting ready for salah, mashallah. And you're anticipating the salah. And you're anticipating the coming of the next salah. And you're getting ready for it. And you're preparing for it. My salah is the most important thing. How many salawat do we make a day? Five times salah we make. And each salah will take you how many minutes? Yeah, and 3 to 5 minutes, 10 minutes maximum. So all your salawat, if you collect all the minutes, it will be how many? 1 hour? Allah gave us 24 hours. Can't we give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 1 hour with khushu'? 24 hours a day. Can't we give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one single hour with focus? Even that 5 minutes you're giving to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're not focused in. We want to focus, inshallah. That khushu' is in this world. Yeah. Focus and humble yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your salah. Khushu', if we just summarize. Khushu', humble yourself and focus on that salah. That 5 minutes you're going to give to Allah, let it be 5 minutes, proper 5 minutes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The time of your salah, let it be a sacred time. So I'm going to make my salah. I don't want any interaction. I don't want any thoughts from outside. I want to focus, inshallah. So you say Allahu Akbar and you start. Now, another tip to help you, inshallah, to develop khushu' in your salah. When you start reading your salawat, your fatiha, your Quran, etc., the reading itself should be in a slow manner. Don't read so quick. And this is one of the mistakes. People read so quick, and then I couldn't figure out. Alhamdulillah. Don't make your main concern or your main worry is to finish the salah. Let be your main concern is to make your salah accepted, not to finish your salah. Right? So I'm not doing my salah to finish it. Or to get done. I'm doing my salah to reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to do my salah to reach to Allah. So if you didn't reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you haven't reached yet, wait. Slow down. You didn't reach yet. Now let me
do it properly. Let me give this ruku' more time. I didn't reach yet. My heart is not there. You say, Subhanallah al-Azim, Subhanallah al-Azim. You want to raise from ruku'. Shaitan wants you to raise quickly. No, wait. Did you reach? Did your heart reach? It reached. Okay, khalas, alhamdulillah. Let me raise from ruku'. Now, you made rafa' from ruku'. And you say, Rabbana wa laka alhamd. Did your heart reach? Your heart is there. It's not there. Wait. It's there. Alhamdulillah. Khalas. Let's go to the sujood. Same thing. Subhana rabbi al-a'la. Subhana rabbi al-a'la. Subhana rabbi al-a'la. Your heart is there. You feel it. Your heart is humble. You understand what you are saying. You don't understand what you're saying. Wait. Add more. Subhana rabbi al-a'la. Subhana rabbi al-a'la. You get your heart. It's there. Okay. Khalas. Now, rafa' from sujood. And likewise, take your time. Take your time. Don't be in a hurry to raise. We want to reach and we want to the salah to be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let us take our time. Let us take our time, inshallah. Another thing also, when you are reciting, you recite in a voice that you can at least hear yourself. Don't make it too soft. You can't even hear yourself. وَلَا تَجْهَرْ بِصَلَاتِكَ وَلَا تُخَافِدْ بِهَا. Don't make it too soft. You can't hear anything and then Shaitan will be easily to whisper for you. But at least hear yourself. Bismillah ar-Rahman. Alhamdulillah. Rahman ar-Rahim. Ya Malik yawm al-Din. Iyyaka na'budu. Yani you hear yourself a little bit while you are reciting. And not when you are an imam. Yani imam, this is different. We're talking about when you are making the salah alone. So we make the salah and your voice, you should at least hear your voice while you're making the salah. Also choosing a sutra. Meaning that if you're making salah and maybe there's some people who's going to come in between, better to put something in front of you. People will know that this is a person is making salah, so no one is going to come across from in front of you. And this will also make you confused. The next point also, we're still in the same etiquettes of khushu' or having khushu', and that is to listen to yourself. We said listen to yourself and hear your voice and understand the words. Ponder over the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to recite some ayat of bushra, ayat of jannah. And then the Prophet would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for jannah. And he'll pass by some of the ayat of azab and punishment. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would seek protection Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from punishment. And this is what you call it interaction, tafa'ul. At-tafa'ul ma'al Qur'an. Interaction with the Qur'an. Even if you are reading as a ma'moom, even if you are behind the imam, and you hear the imam is reciting certain verses of Jannah, etc. Ya Allah, give me that Jannah. Certain verses of Azab, Ya Allah, protect me from this. So this is also from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Salah, which is interaction with the Qur'an, to interact with the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another etiquette also, which is don't make salah bihadrat al-ta'am. Yani people are bringing the food, let me make my salah and then I'll eat. And the food is there already. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, la salata bihadrat al-ta'am, wala bimudafa'at al-akhbathayni. If the food is there, eat first and then make salah. Why? Because if you're going to make salah, your mind will be focused on your food, not on your salah. So let's finish the food and then let's focus now on your salah. For this khushu'a, the Prophet ﷺ advised us to eat first. Why? For this, for you to be able to have khushu' in your salah. You see? The next is also وَلَا بِمُدَافَعَةِ الْأَخْبَثَيْنِ. That meaning that the person have the urge to go to the toilet. If you have the urge to go to the toilet first and then come back. See, but Shaykh, the iqama and you're going to make salah in jama'ah and I'm going to miss the jama'ah. If you have the urge to go to the toilet, go first to the toilet. Because you can make the salah in a jama'ah. It's not accepted because you don't have khushu' and you're thinking of going to the toilet thereafter. No, rather, go to the toilet, finish, and then go and make your salah with khushu'. So you get the thawab of khushu' and you get the thawab of salah, proper thawab for salah. Okay? So we understand this as well. Inshallah. The next point also is that after you finish your salah, now after you are done with your salah, make dua for the acceptance of the salah. Don't think, khalas, I finished my salah, and that's it. But no, we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our salawat. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka anta as-sami'u al-alim. Allahumma inna ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husna ibadatik. And the dua after salah is one of the auspicious times for dua is to make dua after your salah, after khatm al-salah, etc. Subhan rabbi al-a'la 33 times, alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 33 times, we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And dua also in salah, there are positions where you can make dua in salah, such as dua in sujood position, such as the dua between the two sajdas, rabbi ighfirli wa arhamni wa ajburni wa asturni wa arzuqni, etc. From the du'as of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, between the two sajdas. And the dua after innaka hamidun majid, you can also make dua to Allah. And the Prophet has some certain du'a that he used to recite. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min an-nar, salaka al-jannah, a'udhu bika min fitnat al-qabr, wa min fitnat al-mahya wal-mamat, wa min fitnat al-masih al-dajjal, etc. So we can also use this time for dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah give us the ability to perform salah with khushu' and to make us among al-khashi'een. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. It is time for a short break. We'll come back after the break, inshallah.